Hello and welcome to this video. Today I will tell you how to hack your 3DS or how to install the Luma 3DS custom firmware on 3DS systems with the version 11.15.0. And first, you have to check your 3DS system version. You can do that in the system settings. Future or higher versions might be supported as well. I will write the maximum system version into the title and into the description, and then you can check if that's above or below this version here. You can find the version of your 3DS here on the top screen. It's usually something like 11.15 or maybe 11.16 in the future. And you have to compare that with the version in the description or in the title of the video. But now that we've got that and that you checked that the version that you have is supported, we can talk about the options for your 3DS system version. Sadly, the convenient browser hacks got patched with 11.14 or 11.15. So you can't use the browser hacks anymore, but there are a few other options. And the first one is the one that I suggest because that's the most secure one. And it even has some kind of brick protection or you can recover from bricks. And that's by using a DS slash card. It's basically the golden key to the 3DS. And well, you can hack every 3DS and it can't be patched. And it's you need a supported card for that. The best card or the best option would be a card that supports it by the manufacturer, like r4ids.cn. But sadly, these cards aren't being made at the moment. So you have to get one that supports it and is being sold at the moment. And that would be either the cards from r4isdhc.com or r4i-sdhc.com. They've got different cards with different ways or options to do that. Only the label here might be different. It will probably be 2021 in your case. It's the same steps. Just make sure that it's from r4isdhc.com or r4i-sdhc.com. Also, make sure that it isn't the Snoopy version from r4isdhc.com because that one isn't made by this manufacturer anymore. So that's anti-R boot. That's my suggested method, but there are other methods like homebrew entry points. We've got entry points like Cubic Ninja with Ninja Hex or Zelda Ocarina of Time 3D with 3D Hex or OOT 3D Hex. And basically some of these exploits use a file called otherapp, and there's a version of the otherapp payload that can install the custom firmware. I made a tutorial for card DIP hacks, which works with Mario Kart 3DS. So for that, you need a hacked 3DS with Mario Kart 7 and the 3DS that you want to hack. And then you can basically send the custom firmware from one 3DS to the other one. So that's card DIP hacks. I will link it in the annotations as well as a playlist with NTR boot installation guides for different systems. And last of all, there's SeedMiner. I don't like SeedMiner very well because it has, because you have to copy many files and you might do mistakes doing that. But I will link a written description for SeedMiner in the comments or in the description. So you can check that out if you want to use the free option of SeedMiner. But that was it for this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video and bye.